front. It all happens here. Look at that price. Can't be beaten anywhere in Coney Island for the best ride in Coney Island. I am a talking head. Yes, a talking head. I'm talking to you right now. This is Quasimodo. Safari, safari, safari. It's happening now, and it's happening here.
In 1920, my dad was involved with over 100 stockholders to build the WonderWheel, which was an eccentric Ferris wheel at that time. My dad was a grocery man up on Harlem, 127th Street in Park Avenue. That's where I was born, back in 1950. But my dad had the store already in 1903. But then he connected with a lot of restaurant men. That this is not carnival people that got involved in. We had so many different people here that wanted to get involved in Coney Island because Coney Island was very, very well known then.
It was already an amusement park?
Oh yes, definitely, absolutely. We had Dreamland Park, we had Luna Park, we had Steeplechase. The thing that kept Coney Island going, of course, is the beach and the boardwalk, which was built in 1921. The wheel, as I say, rode over 24 million people. It's the safest ride in the world. Has less accidents than any ride. The only things we have is scraped fingers when we open the door. Scrape some of the skin off. Our dogs.
Yeah.
I have four dogs that ride the wheel. They're the watchdogs at night. And they can't wait in the morning to get in there. Why? Because they're through with their watching at night. And they know that they go in a stationary car. That's a car that never moves. And it's all air conditioned, no flies, no mosquitoes, no bugs, no people to bother them.
You want to go up and
shoot
from up there?
And one that doesn't swing.
Oh, of course.
Only because I'm scared, not because...
Well, the film wouldn't come out too good, you know, doing one of those jobs. Yeah, come on, let's go.
Yeah, why don't you tell us about Grandpa?
Oh, Papa. The old, he was amazing man. Amazing man. I really can't believe that the guy came over here and built this thing.
Did you know him?
Oh yeah. He was a cheesemaker over in Germany, Hamburg, Germany. Came over here and worked in a grocery store in Harlem. He lived in Harlem. And I guess he used to come down here, you know, weekends and things like everybody else did. There was nothing around. There was nothing here. It was just the beach, you know, the beach houses and whatnot, some restaurants and things. But there wasn't any rides really were involved at that point. There were a few. Yeah, but you see, the old parks, Luna Park and Dreamland Park, didn't have much in the way of rides. Mechanical rides were a new item. They were a new thing. They had shows. They had menageries. They had things like that. They, you know, other forms of entertainment, exhibits and things like that, but they didn't have mechanical rides. There were hundreds of investors, actually. Most of them small investors. And how he got them to put up the money, and they had the nerve to go and build it.
Who built it?
Well, he built it. He subcontracted out all the other stuff. We had they had a big shop here. They built a big shop, and they cut and punched and drilled and shaped every piece of steel that's on it right here. Well, that's what it was. Their shop was a big factory. My grandfather was here until he was every year. Until he died, really.
Everybody ride the truck around us.
They didn't have any dimes.
They get right over there by the bathroom.
Collect unemployment.
Do a lot of people here do that?
Everybody.
I've been doing repairs, general repairs of machinery, we can say for 50 years or more. That's easy to say.
Is this wheel a big job?
It is. There's quite a bit of maintenance here. Getting more every year.
Older?
As it gets older, there's more every year. It's a constant, it's a constant repair.
Are there pieces of this machinery that you can't replace?
Everything can be replaced. Everything can be made. Well, it's all, after all, it's all steel. You can buy, as long as you can buy steel, you can fabricate. That's all. As long as you got a welding machine, the cutting torch, you can do most anything. Even these motors that were made up special today, we converted. And we're using standard equipment.
And Alice has always worked here too with you?
Well, yeah, we both grew up almost together.
Is she a Coney Island girl, too?
That's right.
Uh-huh.
She's a Coney Island girl. And if you want to know the truth, I take her for help before I take some of the other guys. We have a special gear in here to change. She changes it with me. That's no lie.
No, I was just saying, you do maintenance for other people, too, don't you?
Well, I do a little next door in the kiddie park. And next door here, when they run into trouble, that's about all. When they're in trouble, I try to help them out. That's part of the Coney Island amusement business. Everybody wants to help everybody. One helps the other.
No, don't take his picture because he's wanted, so don't take it.
Is that the truth?
That's what he keeps telling us.
Yeah, he's wanted.
Is this the honest to God truth? No, this is somebody else is wanted. Everybody around here says they're wanted.
We're all wanted.
Have you owned rides here? Or what's yours?
Scooter and Scrambler right next door.
Oh, so they're still yours? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, so you're a neighbor.
I'm a neighbor, right. Yeah, I've been Fred's neighbor for, I guess, about 35 years now.
Down here or in Brooklyn also?
Down here, strictly. Uh-huh. I live in Queens. Uh-huh. But 35 seasons. I was a kid when I met him, and he taught me a lot about Coney Island, and I got to love it. I came down as a mechanic for the kiddie park up there, and spent about 4.5 years as a mechanic. And I said to myself, one day I'd sure like to own something in Coney Island. So I was very lucky at that time. My wife went on a $64,000 program, and she won enough money to put me in business. Yeah. This is an action business. We like people to have a good time. We like a lot of people. Nothing like seeing a million people all congregated in a small area and fighting for Frankfurters and fighting to get on the ride. And when they get on the ride, they don't want to get off the ride. Coney Island itself, all right? There is the word itself, the two words, Coney Island. Throughout the world, the connotation is a honky-tonk good time. And that's exactly what we are. It's a honky-tonk good time.
As this show is. Let's go! Ventero, Vento Clemente, the idol of Puerto Rico. Mira forget this Coney Island Spanish. Mira Fogaki, Mira Lina Medina, Lunica Madre de Monte de Cinco Anda. Have you seen Elvis here? The king of rock, show, rock, rock. Come in and sing with Elvis, come in and rock with Elvis. Let's go! It's the one and only. We're Bobby Kennedy, President Kennedy. She doesn't want to rock with Elvis. You don't know what you're missing, young lady. If you don't see that costume, not that costume, but one of the costumes that he wore on stage, I will return your money. Yes, absolutely. Come and see it all on the inside. Hey there, come on and rock with Elvis.
What about all these fortune-telling faces?
Ah, fun. Nonsense. They tell you good things. They're always telling you you're going to be a millionaire next week. It's worth a quarter to find out you're going to be a millionaire next week. But it's your husband's faithful. I mean, that's not bad, you know. I mean, but they're cute. They bother no one.
Are they gypsies?
Yes.
The same people run storms all over the city?
Yeah, sure. Oh, yeah. They're very authentic and as phony as any $3 bill, but it's fun.
In this business, when you're so concentrated in 14 weeks, If you get a few rainy weekends, you're in trouble. Now let's try with 2 good weekends out of 14. Now, if you don't run a top-notch operation, if you don't have the most efficient men, and if you don't close as soon as it rains, then open when it stops, pretty soon you'll find at the end of the season you can't pay your rent.
This is one day when we wouldn't really need too big of a crew. Well, I don't know. Looks like it's slowing up a bit.
Remember, it never rains in Coney Island, so we'll be going.
I count money, and I lament the loss of a day while it's raining, but I come here for socializing with Fred, or he's always got someone coming through. This is probably the best PR place in Coney Island, you know. The bar is great. Prices are wonderful. And Fred is just one of those outgoing guys that simply likes everyone. So whenever some dignitaries come to Coney Island, we don't bring them up to the chamber office because that's too severe, you know. I mean, they know what they're going to get there. It's practically, you could type it out and hand them out, you know, like the president hands out, you know, for press conferences and stuff like that. But here, people let their hair down. They might have a drink or two, and they tell you what they think of Coney Island, and we learn a lot from that.
You do, though. You get a lot of people with this attitude. Well, you should have seen it in the old days, which is...
Oh, my God. That's all I live with. That's all I live with.
And this was the same as driving nuts.
That's all I live with.
I should have seen it in 1915.
Oh, they go back to the inception of Coney Island when the racetracks were here and when the big hotels and you go to Feltman's, you have to wear a tie and a jacket to order some food and things. My God, times have changed. You don't get people with jackets and ties at weddings and bar mitzvahs today. They walk in casual. So we went along with the time. We didn't resist the times. That's why we're still here. That's why we're still here. We've changed.
Women who own their own rides and concessions, or just mostly men and families?
No, as a matter of fact, we have two great shortages. Number one is women, and number two is blacks. There are very few blacks owning businesses in Coney Island. It is not because they're not allowed to own business in Coney Island, but it is very difficult to get a location. This is a father-to-son business.
You want to go out?
Okay, I'm going back to work, too.
Mike, thank you.
My pleasure.
We're going to come visit you.
Nice to meet you. Okay.
In your next place.
Now maybe you go on the rides.
Okay.
Go on, Mike.
He was really good. He gave us a really nice...
He is good.
Very good, positive.
Very eloquent man.
Yeah.
Okay. Surprised to find somebody like that down here?
No, not at all. Do you have a message for him?
How'd you like my car?
Your friend is so nice.
Isn't he?
He is really nice.
Yeah, I know. If you
and he only said nice things about you.
I like the Harold recording on that one. But we're kind of on the outs right now, the two of us, my dad and I. Yeah. It's a basic father-son problem in a business. You know, I'm an SOB. Son of a boss. When you're my age, you kind of want to have something a little creative, possibly. You know, put a little something of yourself into it. You know, whether it works or it doesn't work, you want to try things. Sign maniac. There was one sign on the wheel, that one on the other side with the bulbs. That was on this side. When he took it down, moved it to the other side, he put that one up, put that one up, put that one up, put the one out on 12th Street.
I put it all the neon lights. I've got 10,000 feet of neon to begin. We maintain. All the stuff outside's got to come in here to with us. That's on the wheel because of ice.
You take all the neon in?
Yeah, that's on the wheel.
Oh, you have a wear band to put in. They call it wear band. The wheel rides on these nine rollers and they wear out every 5 years. You have to put them in. It's a 4 day, it's about 4 to 5 days work.
Who's gonna work with you, the guys?
The fellas, and then I think there'll be another welder. There's quite a few, I mean, that's quite a bit of work.
Why don't you pick it up?
sled went because the family that owned it sold it, and the guy who bought it didn't know how to take care of it, and he ran it into the ground. The same thing happened to the tornado. These are rides that were operated by, you know, by families mostly. And the families took good care of them. When they decided they didn't want any more of it, or they retired and the kids went into something else, somebody else got their hands on it, they didn't put the effort into it that was necessary to keep it running. And the reason the wheel is still here is because it's in the same family still, you know. If we were to sell it to somebody else, I don't think it would last 3 or 4 years.